Welcome to Fit and Flow Yoga Radio. Sit down and tune into the show, tuning out the world around you. This hour will be filled with the serenity and peace you will need from my mat to yours. I am your host, Sherrell, and we will be getting started with your journey in a moment. Hello, everyone, and good morning, and welcome to Fit and Flow Yoga Radio with Sherrell. I'm so glad that you joined me this morning for this wonderful show. Today, the show is entitled Yoga, More Than a Fancy Stretch. I love that title, and I'll tell you a little bit more about how I came up with the title later on in the show. But for right now, we want to Fit and Flow Yoga Radio is happy to be sponsored by Audible.com, a leading provider of spoken digital audio entertainment. They have over 150 titles to choose from, and you can listen to them from any device, including wherever you're hearing us on right now. And if you sign up at their URL, which is audibletrial.com/MWHYLLC, you can get a free audiobook and 1 month trial of the service. So if you're looking for books online, this trial is perfect for you. And we encourage our listeners, especially those here at Fit and Flow Yoga Radio, to go to audibletrial.com/MWHYLLC. So thank you so much, audible.com. We're going to get right into our show today, and I have a couple of announcements, but I kind of want to save those until we get started with the show. Today we're going to be talking about yoga, More Than a Fancy Stretch. I love that title because most people think that yoga really is just, oh, you're just stretching. You know, I see people do this in the gym. Does that mean that they're doing yoga? And I get a lot of, isn't yoga just stretching? Or, you know, do you have to take a class? You know, can't you just stretch on your own and you're basically doing yoga? And so I just want to take a moment, take this broadcast to talk a little bit more about stretching, the benefits of regular stretching, and some of the similarities and differences between part of a yoga class, which a yoga class does not consist of just stretching, and talk about the different postures and how they can be similar to some of the regular stretching that you may see in a gym. And so those are some of the things that we're going to talk about today, and I hope that this will enlighten you about some of the differences. And it's This show today is not to say one is better than the other, okay? It's basically just to kind of let you know what some of the differences are. So the next time maybe someone asks you about yoga or stretching and are they the same, you have a little bit more information to tell the difference. So I first want to start off talking about a typical yoga class. So I'm not going to go into all the different lineages and the different forms of, or the different types of yoga, but most yoga classes that you may find at a gym, at a yoga studio, maybe at your church, or any place. Maybe yoga is offered at your workplace. Some of the components that you're going to see throughout most yoga classes are going to be, one, there's going to be some emphasis on breathing. So that's one of the key components that you may not necessarily see with traditional or regular stretching, you know, at a gym or whatnot. The second component is the component of meditation. And we talked a little bit about that last month in the Power of Meditation broadcast. And that's the component that is very key to yoga. And then the focus of yoga is a little bit different than stretching. So what a lot of people don't realize, because, you know, you may look at a yoga class or be a part of a yoga class and not realize that there are a lot of key things going on when you're in these different yoga postures, okay? So as a teacher, I understand that the focus is not on the end result as it may be with stretching. So with stretching, a lot of times, and I'll just speak from my experience, when I was a gym buff and hadn't discovered yoga yet, you know, what I was always told with being an active person, I ran track, was you want to warm up a little bit, like maybe 10 minutes or so, and then you want to stretch for a little bit, and then you want to get dive right into whatever your exercise is. And then after you exercise, you want to cool down with some stretches, and then you're done. So that was my experience. That's not to say that that's your experience, but that was my experience, and that was my introduction to stretching. Basically, after I warmed up, I would stretch to get prepared for the main event, the main exercise. And then I was told by my coach to prevent any injuries or soreness, that you need to cool down with some nice seated stretches, especially as a runner, some quad stretches, some hamstring stretches. And so that was my experience with it. So for someone that was approaching yoga, I, like so many people, thought that it was the same thing. Oh, it's just a class full of stretches. That's all that it really is. And that's definitely not what yoga is all about. So those are some of the components I want to run through again. One of the key components with a typical yoga class, and once again, disclaimer, all yoga classes may not run like this, but from a general standpoint, there's going to be emphasis on breathing, on meditation, and lastly, postures. And the focus of a yoga class is really on your breath, alignment, and balance, and really bringing the total body into balance. We have a lot of imbalances in our body. It's very typical and very common to hear someone say, oh, my right side is stronger than my left side, or it seems like I can do more on this side than the other side. And that's very common for a lot of us, even me. And when you take a yoga class and you have a consistent practice, the focus of the practice is to learn more about your body. You know, I know that we see all these fun and fancy poses and these different twists and headstands, and all those things are wonderful. But ultimately, yoga is really about trying to bring the body and the mind into balance with one another. And the poses and the other components that I spoke about with breathing and meditation, they all work together and aid in bringing balance to the mind and the body. So that's a little different than your regular stretching. Your stretching exercises that you see maybe a lot of athletes do, or even yourself, you know, maybe you're preparing to jog, you may, you know, stretch a little bit, you jog, you run, you spin, you do Zumba, and then you have like a cool down period at the end, which is great. Let me just say that stretching is great, and stretching is a component of yoga. However, yoga may not necessarily be a component of stretching. So I hope everybody got that. So I'm going to say it one more time. Stretching is definitely a component of yoga because you have your physical yoga postures. However, the system, the health system of yoga is not necessarily what you consider regular stretching. So hopefully everybody kind of understands the difference there. There's a different mindset when it comes to yoga. It's more of a mind-body connection and trying to bring the body into balance. Now, stretching is a part of that, but in most yoga classes, the end goal isn't, oh, let me hurry up and touch my toes. You know, the postures are there to stimulate the organs, to improve circulation, and all these wonderful health benefits kind of come out of it. But those postures are basically put into place to give the whole body a nice total stretch, to prepare the body and the mind for meditation, and once again to bring the body back into balance and to also have some balance within. And so I know it's very, very easy to get caught up with all the physical postures, but there's so much more to yoga than just the physical postures. It's an opportunity for you to get deeper into your body, and the postures are really simply a tool. So let's just take, for example, our typical standing pose. We hinge from our hips and we bend down, and for those that are familiar with regular stretches, the end goal is usually try to touch the toes. Bend over, touch the toes. I hear that all the time. You can't imagine how many times that I hear it, and I said it myself before I started yoga. I can't do yoga because I can't touch my toes. And that mindset really comes from you know, the exercise, just regular exercise, maybe at a gym or a health club, that end result is that is the goal. That is the goal of the stretch. The goal of the stretch is to touch your toes. And for me, in my mind, it said, oh, if I can touch my toes, that means I'm limber. That means I'm flexible. If I can't touch my toes, that means that I failed. I'm not limber, and that I have to keep at it. And my way of keeping at it was to continuously yank my body down to force my fingers to touch my toes, and that can do a lot of damage to your body. I'm sure that those that are listening, you're probably saying, yeah, I can remember, you know, maybe pulling a hamstring, or maybe, you know, God forbid, a tear, or, you know, I hurt myself in some kind of way. And unfortunately, when people stretch, there's not a lot of guidance there. So you really want to, yoga is so great because you have teachers there that are helping you with your alignment. So it's not so much about getting there, but it's how you get there. That's the focus of yoga. I can only speak for myself as a teacher, but I know that the teachers that I learned from and in my experience in training, it's all about how you get into the pose, not the end result of what the pose looks like. Going back to what I said before, the pose is used as a tool so you can get deeper into your body. So let's go back to the example that I just gave. You want to stand up, and you want to hinge and bend from your hips and reaching down and touching your toes. So from a standpoint of regular stretching, that's what you would do. From a yoga standpoint, what you would do is you would make sure that the breath carries you as you float down, bringing your head down below your heart towards the mat. Now, if your fingers reach your toes or reach the mat, that's great. If they don't, that's okay. But the end goal is really to lengthen through that spine, to keep a nice flat back, and to not try to bend the back and hunch over. And so when you have that right alignment, that really is going to help with your posture. You're going to get a nice hamstring stretch when you contract the quads. See, these are all the cues and different things that you're going to get in a yoga class that you may not necessarily think about when you're doing a quick 5 to 10 minute stretch. So that's one of the that's just a couple of the differences that I wanted to go over. Regular stretching does have its place. According to the American Council on Exercise, they highly recommend stretching if you're someone that's active, because stretching has been proven to increase circulation, to help with posture, and it's just overall just a good practice. It definitely helps with flexibility, and all of those things are byproducts of stretching. As I mentioned before, stretching is a part of yoga, so you're still going to get the benefits if you decide, you know, I'm going to run, I'm going to jog, and I'm going to do some light stretching. However, it's very important to understand the difference with the mindset that comes maybe with just a regular stretch, which is totally physical sometimes and not necessarily considering the mind-body connection, the breath carrying you through the stretch. When I teach my classes, I tell my students, you know, as you inhale, imagine that you're creating space in the body, and then as you exhale, just imagine that your body is opening up. And just see if your body can go a little bit deeper on that exhale. So it's not, you're never yanking your body into a pose. You're never forcing yourself into any type of stretch to magically make your muscles longer, because that's not the way that the muscles work. I could do a whole nother show on strengthening the muscles and elongating the muscles, but muscles aren't really they're not like just a piece of taffy that you just pull and they get long. That's not how it works. And I laugh because I thought that's how it worked, you know, so many years ago, not really understanding how the body works. So yoga And the way that yoga works is that yoga teaches you how to relax. I spoke on one of my shows before talking about the nervous system, why yoga is so key and really helps with people that deal with stress, because it really taps into the parasympathetic nervous system that causes everything, all the nerves in the body to relax. And that's really what helps your muscles. Isn't it amazing sometimes for those of us that have a yoga practice or we stretch, that as we relax and we stop focusing on, I got to touch my toes or I got to do this back bend, and we just breathe into it, before you know it, you're further down than you ever thought, because you're actually relaxing in the pose and you're not so agitated and your muscles aren't so contracted that you're trying to force yourself into a pose. So for me, that was the aha moment. That was the moment that, okay, now I get it. The body will open when the body is relaxed. I hope that's a light bulb for you too. So those are just some of the things that I kind of want to talk about in the first half of our show. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back.
Hi, this is Capri Smith of the Uncuffed Radio Show. Join me every Saturday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn how you can grow in your business, personal environment, and reach your true potential by uncuffing what is binding you, only on the Maybe Help You Radio Network.
Incarceration doesn't just affect the one behind bars. It affects everyone. Here's your chance to let others know that being locked up leaves others locked down on the outside, hurting emotionally, economically, and spiritually. We want to know how you feel. Go to www.lovelockdownseries.com and make your creative voice heard. Lovelockdownseries.com. We are listening.
The Queen Esther Radio Show is live every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Join me, Jessica Taylor.
And me, Jason Mosley, to be entertained by authors, artists, and spiritual leaders.
We look forward to being a blessing in your life every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Only on the MWHY Radio Network.
I'm Tanya Free. What does it mean to be a teacher? Perhaps it's easier to define what a teacher is not. The 11 Atlanta teachers recently convicted of standardized test cheating. Investigators said the teachers held cheating parties where incorrect answers on student tests were erased, changed, and corrected. What were they thinking or not thinking? Then there are those that won't let go of the past. The sons of Confederate veterans in Texas are proposing a license plate with the rebel battle flag. After several votes, the DMV rejected the proposed plate. The sons of Confederate veterans sued over violation of free speech and won in federal appeals court. Texas has appealed to the Supreme Court. Stay tuned. The battle continues. Finally, does driving while black mean you can't drive a luxury car? Well, actor Isaiah Washington has some advice for Chris Rock, who has been pulled over 3 times in less than 2 months. Get rid of your luxury car like he did and buy 3 Priuses. Really, Isaiah? Let's talk about it. Join the conversation. These stories and more. Wednesday on a Tanya Free and Friends talk show and 24/7 on TanyaFree.com. Until then, be free and remember to live life with a purpose.
The Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show, your destination for the best in social and political straight talk, Wednesdays at 2 p.m., streaming live on TanyaFree.com and BlackTalkRadioNetwork.com. Join the conversation Wednesdays at 2 p.m.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back. Thank you once again so much for joining me. I have a couple of announcements before we get back into our show. I mentioned this on the last broadcast that we had, and I just want to bring it back to your remembrance in case you forgot to jot it down. We have 2 announcements. One is the 6th semi-annual Women's Entrepreneurial Expo, and that's going to be happening on April 25th, that's a Saturday, at 10 a.m. at the Signature Blue Events. That is on 337 Bright Seat Road, Suite 220. And the expo is a business event that is focused on small businesses, women-owned businesses, and new businesses. And the event prides itself on business revitalization, as well as providing consumers with tools and contacts to learn, connect, and network. So this is a great event for those business owners, or you're thinking about starting your own business. Definitely put this on your calendar. Once again, this is scheduled for Saturday, April 25th at 10 a.m. And to find more information about this, you can contact Joan. And the phone number is 240-423-1628. And you can visit the website for additional information at www.womenexpo.info. That is one great event. And then we have our very own MWHY radio event. We're going to be having a huge Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise Expo. And this is a little ways off, but go ahead and mark your calendars for Saturday, September 12th, from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And once again, this is – oh, I forgot to mention for the other event, both events are free, everybody, free. So you have no excuse. The MWHY Expo for Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise is going to be amazing. There are going to be over 10,000 attendees. There are going to be live performances, hosts from the network, and entertainers. Once again, this is Saturday, September 12th, and you can get your free ticket at healthywealthywiserva.eventbrite.com. And this event is going to be held at the Chesterfield Town Center Mall, and we look forward to seeing everyone there for this already blessed event. So those are just some of the announcements that we had that we wanted to just share with you all, share with the community. These free events don't come around all the time, so definitely take advantage of them. Invite your family, your friends, your coworkers. Everybody can benefit from these types of events. So we're going to go ahead and get back into our show talking about yoga, more than a fancy stretch. So I mentioned at the top of the show that I would tell you about how I came up with the title. And actually, I didn't come up with it on my own. I actually saw an article in the New York Post some years ago. I was just doing some research. And the person that wrote the article was basically saying yoga is kind of just a fancy stretch. It's boring. You know, you add a little flair to it, and it really just amounts to stretching. And for me, I thought it was pretty funny. So I wanted to automatically, as soon as I read the article, I wanted to do a show on it, yoga, more than a fancy stretch. And it definitely is more than just a fancy stretch. I know that media can, you know, really impress upon us that this is yoga, what they have in the magazines, on Instagram, on TV. And it really is so much more than what we all see. And for those that are able to take a class, I really recommend that you find somewhere that, first of all, you're comfortable, maybe at your local gym, your church, maybe you have classes that are available to you at work, and just give it a try. Go with an open mind, an open heart, and just find out those areas that really speak to you in a yoga class, and if you have your own yoga practice at home. And you'll definitely reap some of the benefits and understand a little bit more about why it's a little bit more than stretching. I tell you, science and the researchers have been really doing a lot of research on this for the past couple of years, and I just want to go over just some of the ways that yoga really helps the body. I know that a lot of us know the obvious. You know, we see people being flexible. They're able to touch their toes. They're doing back bends and headstands. That's kind of the obvious. But I want to talk a little bit more about those things that aren't so obvious, like improving your lung function. You know, we don't put a lot of credence into the importance of breathing. It's always, you know, things that don't seem, the things that we don't think about the most, that when we lose them, they all of a sudden become very important. There are people that have an issue breathing. I've actually work with older clients that they come to yoga solely to breathe better. They want to improve their posture. their shoulders are hunched over and they cannot breathe. Can you imagine that? You know, for many of us, whether you're young, old, if you're in pretty decent health, can you imagine beyond the headstands and the strength and the flexibility, just the overall day-to-day, you feel like you can't breathe? I mean, that's a very scary thought. And some people live life that way. So a lot of us, if we have any pains in our bodies or we have problems breathing, what do we normally do, everybody? We kind of just get used to it, you know. And a lot of older people that have breathing issues, some get used to it, and some try to seek out resolutions to help their breathing. So yoga definitely helps with lung capacity, being able to breathe more deeper, more fuller. Some of the other benefits that are not so obvious have to do with the function of our feet. I'm always so surprised when I teach a class and maybe a new person comes in and they don't want to take off their socks or they don't want to take off their shoes, or they say, well, do I have to take off my shoes? And being barefooted and being able to have full mobility of our feet and our ankles is very important to the health of the rest of our limbs. We don't realize how connected our body really is. You know, it's not just strong legs, strong calves, strong quads, but it all starts down at the root. It starts down with the feet. So yoga definitely helps with your feet and the strength of your feet and just being more aware of how your feet work and how they carry us. Isn't that, God is so good. I mean, he gives us two strong feet to carry us day in and day out, and sometimes we neglect our feet and don't think about all the pressure that we're putting on our feet day in and day out, and yoga definitely brings some awareness to that. Some of the other obvious benefits have to do with our bone strength. Our bones get stronger when you have a active and consistent yoga practice. You notice that I put those key words in there. So it's not just doing yoga once a week, or you did it 1 month and it felt good and you don't revisit it again to another month. A consistent practice, okay? One of the other benefits of improved brain function. So I spoke a little bit about this with the power of meditation, that when we meditate, especially Christian meditation, when we meditate on the Word of God, how our brain function changes. Our brain function can also change during meditation with bringing more clarity. Sometimes when we lack sleep or we deal with stress, you can engage in yoga, and it helps with clarity. The postures, the meditation, and the breathing all work together to affect various systems in our body. And then lastly, I just want to talk a little bit about yoga and its effect on the nervous system. And for those that missed that show, please go back and listen to that show where I talk about the parasympathetic nervous system and how important it is in bringing relaxation to our bodies and our minds, and how that plays a part in how we deal with stress. And all those things are so important, and those are just a few of the benefits of yoga. And stretching doesn't necessarily deal with some of these mind-body benefits. It doesn't deal with some of those benefits on a deeper level. And many of us, including myself, when I was just doing stretching, just regular gym stretching, you know, after warm-up and at cool-down, you don't really think about it. You know, it's kind of just something that you do. Someone told me to do it. They said that it was good to do, and it feels good when I do it, and I'm just going to do it. But just know that there are some differences. Regular stretching has its place, and yoga has its place, okay? So I want to go ahead and go into our nutritional tip of the week. So this is something new that I'll be starting for our shows, providing a nutritional tip to help many of us with our diet. So we all know that Exercise is very important, but nutrition and what we put into our bodies is just as important as well. And I just want to give some tips for many of us. I've already shared with everyone, I'm not a vegetarian, I'm not a vegan. What I try to do is I try my best to eat clean. I try to put things into my body that are going to fuel my body and not necessarily just the things that my flesh wants, the things that my body wants, because everything that you want, you don't necessarily need. So we want to really fuel our bodies and try to gradually, I know it's hard, it's so hard for me to gradually cut out those things that do not serve us well. And one of the things that I want to talk about, don't be upset, is sugar. I know it's a hard one for me too. So my tip of the day is gradually trying to eliminate the amount of sugar in our diets. Sugar is the culprit behind weight gain. A lot of people really don't realize that. We emphasize fat a lot of times, but sugar can be the culprit as well. And then sugar can also increase our glucose levels, which we all know plays a part in diabetes. So you definitely want to just take a moment to look at what you're putting in your mouth on a regular basis. How much sugar, you know, does that snack have? How much sugar are you using to cook with on a regular basis? How much sugar for those fast food days that we just grab a meal here or there have sugar in them? And so one of the tips that I really like and I started incorporating is the tip to try an extract instead of sugar. So for many of us that cook, instead of using sugar, maybe try almond, vanilla, orange, or a lemon extract instead. And I tell you, when I started adding lemon and vanilla, which are two of my favorite flavors, I didn't even notice that I needed the sugar. It tastes just as good. So this is just one of my tips. There are so many different things that you can do to eliminate or cut down the sugar in your diet. And the tips are simply, I'm providing these tips so that you don't have to worry about trying to do everything at once. This is the thing, people, I tell everyone. You didn't get into this situation overnight. Okay, whatever you're dealing with, and it's not a bad thing. We all come to this stage in our lives, and it didn't just happen overnight. Whether we're dealing with weight, whether we're dealing with lack of range of motion, whatever it is, it didn't just happen overnight. So it's going to take you a minute to slowly bring your body back into balance by maybe changing parts of your diet and changing how you move through life. And so give yourself an opportunity to do that by taking various tips, trying them out. If it doesn't work, maybe try something else. That's what I always do. Just try something else, okay? So that's my nutritional tip for the week. And we're going to go ahead and recap the show and go right into our meditative moment, which I'm sure everybody's excited for and ready for. And I'm going to also walk you through a pose that you can use during meditation that's going to really help open up your hips, open up your heart, and just really embrace the meditative moment if you're in a space where you're alone and you can actually lie down. So we'll be right back in a few.
Hey there, I'm Rita Ricks, host of Spirit Journeys Radio. Our theme for April is being authentic. During this month, you will learn what it means to be authentic. You will learn how to demonstrate authenticity. You will know what it feels to live authentically and how others recognize your authentic self. Life is so much easier when you live your life as you. And do you know why? Because there isn't anyone else on this planet who can be you better than you. So join me every Tuesday evening at 8 o'clock to listen live and chat with me. I'm Rita, speaking to your spirit.
If you're the parent of a child with behavioral challenges that has been suspended, expelled, or just not able to make it in a traditional school setting, there is an alternative. Call the Metropolitan Day School today. Licensed and accredited grades K through 12. Call 804-321-2595. Financial assistance and after-school programs are available. Let's turn this school year around right now at the Metropolitan Day School, where eagles soar. Call Ms. Thomas today. 804-321-2595.
Are you frustrated, disappointed, discouraged with your life? Are you angry with God? What's holding you back from fulfilling your purpose? Are you struggling as a leader in ministry? Do you believe you have an end-time calling? If you answered yes to any of these questions, tune in to The Waymakers on MWHY Radio Network every other Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We are here to support you. Join us to get the answers that will prepare the way of the Lord in your life.
Hi, my name is Letitia M., owner of May We Help You Network. I want to thank you for joining us and enjoying our host here on MWHY Radio Network. Please visit us online at MWHYradio.com and like us on Facebook.com/MWHYradio. Tune in to learn more about our host and upcoming contest and our TV programming that'll be coming to you soon. MWHY Radio, bringing together business, community, and you.
Hello, and welcome back, everyone. Before we go into our recap in our meditative moment, I want to just take another moment to make a quick announcement. We're currently surveying our listeners and our viewers to learn more about you. So please take a few minutes and visit our website. And you can go ahead and click on the listener survey link that's found on the home page. Thank you all so much for participating in that. And then we also would like everyone to help assist May We Help You Radio raise funds today so we can continue to grow. If you will text the word SHOP MWHY to the number 70000 to receive deals on the places you like to shop for free. And you can cancel the service at any time, but the longer you keep the service, the more earning potential we have. Thank you so much. Go ahead and take note for those announcements. And we're going to go right back into our recap, focusing on yoga, more than a fancy stretch. So I spoke about a lot of different things, and I'm hoping that everyone got this and a light bulb went off at some areas, some part that really spoke to you and your spirit. So I really broke down what a typical yoga class consists of and some of the things where stretching is similar to yoga. And I hope that I pressed upon everyone the importance of both. So this is the thing. The bottom line, do something other than just cardio. If you listen to my Fitness 101, you know about the various elements of fitness, but you know that cardio, endurance, flexibility, body composition, all those things have their place and are very important. And so it's always good to have balance in your life. So you can't have all this strength but no flexibility. And then you can't be super bendy with no strength. You know, you can be those things. I'm sorry. You can definitely be those things, but you want to have some balance. So the goal is to seek that balance, to have that strength, but to be able to move. I tell the story all the time that I get a lot of men in my class sometime that are really big and bulky guys, but have all the strength but no flexibility, aren't able to twist, to bend, to move, to pivot their body in different directions. And they're not poses that aren't necessary, that are advanced, but they're poses that are very relatable to just regular functional movements in everyday life. So if we drop something, we want to be able to bend over and pick it up. If we look behind ourselves, we don't want to turn our whole body and look behind ourselves. We want to be able to just turn our neck and look behind us. I gave the story a couple of shows ago how I didn't realize how stiff I was until someone said, you know, when I called your name, you turned your whole body around. I mean, that had really become my norm. And so we want to break out of those norms and form new body movements, new habits, new patterns in the way that we move and the way that we think. And that's why I really, really enjoy the practice of yoga. And so that's kind of just a quick recap about some of the things that we spoke about. Just want to really, really emphasize regular stretching definitely has its place. It's great. If you're stretching after your warm-up and you're stretching during a cool-down, continue to do that, people. Please continue to do what you're doing. It has its benefits. But if you would like to add to your fitness routine, your exercise regimen, and pick up a yoga class just to see how it can benefit what you're already doing, I definitely encourage that you do that, okay? So we're going to go right into our meditative moment, but before we go into the moment, the meditative moment, I want to walk everyone into a meditative posture if you're able to. So let me just say, for those where you don't have space to lie down, you can simply just sit in a chair. That's fine. Or you can sit on the floor with your legs crossed. For those that have maybe a little bit more privacy, a little bit more room, you can go ahead and sit on your bottom and lie all the way back, either on your floor or on your mat. If you have some pillows nearby, that'll be great. You can prop the pillows behind your back so that you have some cushion. And then you're going to take the soles of your feet together and allow your knees to splay out to the side. This is called recline bound angle pose or butterfly pose. You may see this pose a lot when people are sitting down and they have their feet together, but this is so restorative and so relaxing if you will allow your torso, your back to lie all the way back, even on a pillow, or if you can lay all the way back onto a mat, your back or on the floor, and just allow the legs, the knees to open, and just close your eyes and begin to breathe nice and deep, relaxing the face, relaxing your arms beside your torso, and just allowing the knees to soften. Now, if this feels a little uncomfortable for you, you can simply bring the knees back together and you can still remain lying on the floor, on your bed, or on your mat. If you would like the knees to splay open, if you have some pillows, some blocks, you can place them underneath your knees if you have the tendency to tense up around your inner thigh muscles, okay? So just take a moment to get into the posture that works best for you and your body at this moment. And the scripture that we're going to focus on this morning is 1 Peter 2:24. And it reads, "He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been made whole." And just allow that scripture to meditate to your soul, to your heart, and to your mind. As you breathe in this scripture, take a nice inhale through the nose and exhale out even slower through the nose. Allow God's promise in his word to bring you comfort not just mentally, but physically. His word says, by his wounds, you have been healed. That's past tense. Not you will be healed, not you're going to be healed, but you have been healed. Take a moment to think about what that means to you at this moment. As you allow your body to totally relax and your mind to focus and meditate on God's word, breathe in healing and everything that that means to you right now. Knowing that God has the power to restore, to heal, to mend, to make whole. The price was paid, and you have been healed. Take two more deep breaths. Inhaling and exhaling out through the nose. Slowly open the eyes. And take a moment to thank God for his grace and his mercy and his love that is ever present in your life. Thank you all so much for joining me this morning. I'm always so thrilled to do these shows and to just share a little bit about my knowledge of yoga and fitness, and hopefully bring a little bit more information and enlightenment into what your understanding of yoga and fitness is. As we close out another great show, if you're interested in learning more about the services that I offer through Fit and Flow Yoga with Sherrell, please check out my website at www.fitandflowllc.com. You can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and you can find me on Instagram as The Flowing Yogi. Thank you all so much. If you visit my website, you'll see a couple of new articles that I've written for Faith and Fitness magazine, and you'll also see some videos that I've done. So definitely, if you have an opportunity and you have some free time, about 10 minutes or so, go ahead and click on one of my videos and let me know what you think. Family, thank you all so much for joining me this morning. I really, really enjoy sharing this information with you. Be blessed, and remember, when life happens, always breathe in God's goodness, surrender to your power, and embrace your flow. And until next time, be blessed.